profession, as demonstrated by the outstanding contributions they have made to those fields. We are pleased to present the award tonight and to introduce our award winner, John Buckley.
Mr. Chair, TIPS members, distinguished guests. It is my honor tonight to introduce you to our Robert McKay Award winner for teaching excellence. And it is my challenge tonight to try to do so in less than 2 minutes. I also have the challenge of trying to summarize the career of an icon in a very short period of time, and an Irish icon at that. So you will find out in the next minute and a half, I hope, that I've gone a little bit off the board and done something rather unconventional in order to do that. But while we wait for the delivery, let me say a few things about our honoree tonight, Terry McCarthy. There are many ways to teach, and teaching in the classroom is just one of them. Terry has taught John Marshall in Chicago, Stetson in Florida, and also across the pond at Trinity. That is really not what he is known for with regard to his teaching. There's teaching in the courtroom, and lawyers from around the city would come to the Dirksen Federal Building when Terry McCarthy was trying a case, trying to pick up some tips. There is writing. Terry McCarthy shared his method of cross-examination with us, published by the ABA 7 years ago, and still the ABA best-selling book. Terry is known as one of the most frequent and outstanding CLE speakers. Ah, there we go, the delivery. Speaking for us in a number of venues, including Hawaii, where we suffered from some really serious attendance problems in Hawaii, except for Terry's program, which sold out. Not only did it sell out, but the fire marshal came and would not let anyone else come in and sit on the floor because we had the floor filled with people wanting to hear Terry talk about cross-examination. But in addition to that, you can teach by example. Terry has taught us many things by example, not only how to cross-examine a witness, how to impeach a witness, but how to live life with grace and dignity. Terry has always been open to us. He's talked to us many times, and when he's not speaking, McCarthy's bar is always open at the table where he is, and I'm sure tonight the stories will go on until they kick us out the door. So, the best way to introduce our award winner, the true Irishman, is with a toast. Terry, on behalf of the TIPS section, thank you for a lifetime of learning, laughter, and libations. You will always be loved here and never forgotten. Thank you.
Gotcha.
Thank you.
fights are ferocious. Now I know what my client is to go through. But John, where is John? I can't find, there he is. John, thank you very much for the glowing remarks. I only wish that my sainted mother were here tonight. She, John, would have believed everything you said. And in that sense, she would have been totally unique, of course. I thank John. John is the main reason, I think, that I am given this very prestigious award, for which I am grateful, okay? So thank you very much, John. There's another young man here today that I just want to, I think I'm entitled to say a few words about. He's a little younger than John. He looks much younger, but he's a little younger. But my son, Sean, is here. Sean was kind enough to give up his weekend up at our lake place to come here with me to the town of the Bean and the Cod. But for Sean coming here, actually, rather not surprising, because Sean is a heck of a lot like you people. Since he started practicing law, he has, as many of you do, he has represented the Holy Grail insurance companies, okay? So that's what Sean does, and I'm very proud of him. As a matter of fact, I decided I would tell this quick story. But about a month ago, Sean was finishing up a week-long trial. I was in the courtroom the final day, and as I was walking out of the courtroom, and I'm stumbling out of the courtroom, but as I was leaving the courtroom, very unique, the two lawyers opposing Sean made it a point to come up to me, and they were both seasoned lawyers, and they told me, Mr. McCarthy, why I didn't call him Mr., I don't know, but that we wanted to tell you that your son Sean is the best trial lawyer we've ever opposed. And I mean, there's a lot of parents in this room, and as parents, you know, there is nothing that makes you happier than to hear somebody tell you something nice about one of your children. So I was very pleased. Talking about trial advocacy, which I sort of backed into here, I've spent an awful long time in courtrooms in my unillustrious career as a trial lawyer. I've tried tons of jury cases. Indeed, I venture to say I have managed to lose more jury cases than anybody in this room. As a matter of fact, it was usually said that I was the main cause for overcrowding in the federal penitentiary. That was so until the federal sentencing guidelines came out. The worst piece of legislation that Congress of the United States has passed in the last 50 years. Where those, and again, they started right here in Boston. But those damn guidelines, they were horrible, okay? But one of the advantages of losing cases in the district court is you get to appeal.
Yes.
And so I spent a lot of time up in the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals. Okay, that court has changed drastically from when I started and now. But in any event, I argued up there. And I'm tremendously proud of this, I actually had two cases in the United States Supreme Court. And that was just a wonderful, wonderful experience, okay, having the two. By the way, I won one of those cases. So my batting average in the Supreme Court is 500. I mean, that's a hell of a lot better than my batting average down below. Let me tell you. Okay? Matter of fact, I wasn't going to mention, but I am. right behind my desk, up on the wall behind where I sit, I have a picture. And I treasure the picture. It's a picture of the United States Supreme Court, their official photograph. And each and all of the justices signed it for me and sent it to me. So, you know, I'm rather proud of that. But now let me tell you something that's going to shock you. I spent much time in courtrooms, of course, and I've enjoyed it. I've enjoyed going and trying cases and what have you. But my true love, ever since I started practicing law, has not been trying jury cases or arguing appeals or anything like that. My true love has always been and is today teaching. Teaching other lawyers, teaching law school students. We have one young man over there. And even teaching, believe it or not, if it's possible, teaching judges, okay? So, oh, I've taught at the Federal Judicial Center and all kinds of places. But I've enjoyed that. The teaching part is the part I enjoy. And apropos that comment, this wonderful award which you give me, the McKay Award, is going to have a special place in my heart because this award is for teaching. And that's the thing I told you I love to do. So I can't find people around here with the lights, but Mr. Chair and each and all, where is it? Right there.
Mr. Chair.
Oh, there he is. Okay. I can't see anything with these lights. But thank you very, very much. And I thank each and all of the members of your illustrious section. You do yourself proud in what you do and be proud of it. Thank you very much.